Welcome to Science Lab Lab Lab, where every week we publish a new science educational video. If you're looking for a fun home science experiment you can safely do with your little ones, you're going to love this DIY lava lamp project. Not only are they beautiful to watch, it is a great chemistry educational opportunity. If you'd like the free downloadable worksheet that goes with this video, go to www.sciencelablablab.com/DIY lava lamp. Let's jump into the experiment. To start your DIY lava lamp, you're going to need a clear container. We're going to use a small cup, but you can use a 20-ounce soda bottle or any liquid container that you can see through. You will need a type of transparent oil. We're using vegetable oil, which has a little bit of a yellow tint to it. You will also need water, food coloring, and Alka-seltzer tablets. We started with a small amount of water in the cup. We will show you later that different size containers and different ratios of oil and water will make differences in how your lava lamp looks. Next, pour the oil into your container. You want the oil to be 3/4 the container or more, with 1/4 or less of water. In this first experiment, we're going with more than 3/4 oil, closer to probably 9/10. Add several drops of food coloring. We added about 13 drops to this one, which is a good number, but feel free to experiment. Once you let it settle for a minute or two, add the Alka-Seltzer tablets and watch the results. If you're using a container that has a cap, make sure to leave the cap off. Why does this mixture of water, oil, Alka-Seltzer tablets, and food coloring act this way? It comes down to the fact that oil and water don't mix. Why doesn't oil and water mix? Water molecules are what are called polar molecules, which means that they like to bond with other polar molecules. Oil is a non-polar molecule. This causes oil and water to stay separate from each other. You'll notice that the oil will float on top of the water. This is because of water molecules are closer together, which makes them more dense. Remember, water is more dense than oil, so the water sinks and the oil floats on top. The food coloring is water-based, so it behaves like water and sinks. As it travels through the oil, it sometimes forms an oil bubble around it, so it will look like droplets in the water. But the food coloring will eventually mix with the water because both the water and the water-based coloring are both polar molecules. Then comes the Alka-Seltzer tablet. These tablets contain citric acid and sodium bicarbonate, which is baking soda. When they drop into the water, the acid and the base have an opportunity to mix, causing a chemical reaction. This reaction creates CO2 gas, which is less dense than the water and oil, so it floats to the top, creating pockets, bubbles, and general disturbance in the colored water and oil mixture. This forms the beautiful display of the lava lamp. Thank you for joining us in this fun science experiment. Feel free to share your video or photos of your final lava lamp
to science@sciencelablablab.com or upload your photos or videos to Facebook and tag us at @sciencelablablab.
Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you're interested in educational science videos. This is Jason Love with Science Lab Lab Lab. Thank you for joining us and have a science-filled day.